the corner, go over and play man to man, we tag it with a zero. Okay? So it'll be like money times zero. So the corner would have to go over. For the first DB outside of the trade formation, we would make a corner call, and the corner would go over. So it'd be a corner cast. Okay? From a coverage standpoint, you can see right here, we're telling you when you play fire zone man. Okay? It says wall left, and he's playing fire zone man on number two. Okay? We've got the Mac backers playing fire zone man on three. The money's playing fire zone man on two. Fire zone man here. But these two guys are playing it with rigorous principles. Okay? The thing you have to be aware of, okay, as your wall flat player on number two, is if three goes away and they run a slant, you got to take it back. Okay? Because we're losing that fourth underneath the dropper that's going to be probably leading that zone, whatever pressure we got. Same deal here. The fire zone man, safety's coming down, they have a fire zone man. The money's playing fire zone man. Fires on a man with rigorous principles. Okay? Does that make sense? So we've taught that in day one in middle of the field coverages. We put our middle of the field pressures in, and we've already taught those guys how to play this on a man. Okay? Okay, so right here, for us, this will be tight left, sting left. So the first DB outside, he's going to come down. It's going to look just like cover six where we've got weak rotation. But basically, we're going to fire the safety. And everybody's going to move one gap up front, and then we're going to have a five-man pressure. So we're going to play a fire zone man here. He fires on man on the tight end. He's got number three. Okay, he's got number four. He's number five, and he's in the middle of the field. Okay, so as you see this, what we teach this guy is number 19. His job is to go underneath the first block. If he's on him to him, he's going to play the B-gap. He knows he's going to play the edge. Okay? We're stepping to the B-gap. He's going to set the edge. Now, these guys are going to pass this off as these two guys cross. So we should have 35 on the back. We should have 34 on the tight end. Okay? So going back to the top with your free through question. Let's say this wasn't a run. Let's say this tight end came through and went to the flat. To him, that would be free through. So make sense? So now you've taught the concept and you should understand that he's got to take free through. Unless he gets an undercall. If he gets an undercall, when this guy came through, he would get sewn up underneath. So if they ran any kind of slant and this tight end came to the flat, he's gonna stay under, he's gonna squeeze it and take that. As he comes off, he's gonna sewn up underneath the slant. Okay, same call right here, should be the safety. So this would be tight right sting right here. You can see right here, he's playing fire zone man. To him, that's really a thunder call. He's got to go get it because it's fire zone man. The only thing we tell our hook three players is, you're going to play it from a no cover zone, all right? We game plan that each week based off whatever the running backs do. If we want them to close to the back, then we would call something like sting to the tight end with zero coverage. Now we're playing straight man. No rip blitz principles apply to it. So you can see here, that's why this guy didn't know getting it. He played in his zone. To him, that's under. So he just goes on this thing out and drop 5 in. This should be tight right sting right. Okay, so this is 3x1. So this would be called tight left, steam lift, and now the star's gonna come. So it's the first DB outside the tight end. He's gonna run the steam. Okay, he's gonna come down and play fires on the end. These guys got one and two. The money back has got number three. He's got four to first. He's man to man, playing it all over. It's a good simple pressure. It's just a 5-man fire on one linebacker DB, depending on what it is. Okay, here's our four open. What we call four open is this four open receiver. The adjustment here is we would rather DBs cover than the linebackers run the pressure. So what we've done here is we made an adjustment where the linebacker's going to come over. He's going to swing off the edge and the safety's going to come down and play fire. Any questions? I mean, that's simple right here. We can run this as many different ways as we want to run, okay? I didn't show you anywhere our defensive line drops, okay? So what we do is we categorize our pressures by name. Anything that is a weapon, no D lineman drop. So we've got steam, we've got hatchet. Let's see what else we have. We've got arrow fire zone, things like that. We categorize them as a weapon. Anything that's categorized in a fire zone is a city. Okay, or a state, Texas, Saratoga, anything is a city or state that a D lineman has to drop. Okay, so now we're bringing an inside back and an overhang in our D lineman drop. So we just try to put these in the markets so that these guys can understand it. So when they hear, if I'm a DN and I hear tight steam, I ain't got to drop. If I hear strong fire zone, okay, or Texas, anything like that, I know I've got to drop. Okay. And then he would play off of what we all know. He's either going to be wall flat or he's going to be able to recall. Okay. All right, this one here, this is more of a two-back type deal, 12 personnel out of our regular package. It's Sonic, but we're going to play two roll coverage with it. So we're going to trap to the field, and we're going to roll the coverage over the top. We like this one here, okay? So typically, we put it in as a field call, okay? It's always on the hash. We run the pressure from the field. But you can see right here, what we do is this, okay? So we're trying to show, we're gonna make this look like the very first clip when we talk about base strong 3-eye. So this safety will come down to the field and make it look like we're going to the middle of the field. This safety will roll to the middle here so that the quarterback thinks that it's middle of the field coverage. Then we roll over the top and we trap to the field, okay? So looking at the pressure, okay, we're in base defense. All we're going to do, we tell the outside back, he's going to be in a track man, he's going to be a little bit heavy. We tell him to blow. For us, the blood technique is to go underneath the first block that shows. Okay? So if they zone to the left, he's going to go underneath the tight end of the seat here. If they were to go full slide on this, and the fullback comes to him, so they slide here, and the fullback comes, he's got to go underneath the fullback. We want him to break the pocket. That's a blood technique. The strong safety, his tab is off the edge, okay? He's going to spill any runs out to the trap corner, okay? And he's going to contain any passes. He's the contained rusher, okay? Our tackle, what we tell him to do is he's going to step to the shoulder of the guard. If the guard's coming to him, we want him to work to the A-gap. If the guard's away, we want him to come off of his ass and run the play down if he's running away. Nose. Because we don't want this guy to get overtaken. What we tell him is he just step to the back half of the center. Okay? This guy's playing two gap, he's just gonna step to contain. Now this is where we drop our outside back. Okay, our outside back plays a slice technique. We tell him to open up and run out of bounds at 10 yards. You're basically coming in points. The boundary corner is gonna get off and he's gonna play the back half. This guy's gonna play the front half. Okay? Now, what we tell these two guys right here, okay, you're going to cut on number two. So when we tell them to cut, they've got that guy, he's on number two, you got him vertical and back foot off. If he goes out, you work for number one. So if you got curl flat concept, this guy goes out for the next one. Okay, if they ran any kind of flow pass, what we call flow pass, both backs go strong, and this guy's going to be cut. If they gave us 3-by-1, he would cut on 2, he would be playing cut on 3, up and back with 1. Okay? Same principles here. This is just just a field boundary call. He's running a blood path. The inside back is going to be the container rush. The strong safety's cutting on two, track flats, falling over the top here, to have a slice and out of bounds, out of bounds 10 yards, running the same pressure. Okay? We like this, okay, whenever there's a tight end oriented team. Somebody asked about Coach Molina, he's still here. He asked about breakdowns, okay? We want to look at our opponent, okay? And we want to find out, are they running to the tight end? Is that where most of their runs go? If it's the one back look like we had earlier, and it was tight sting, and we think most of the runs are going to the tight end, then we would call tight sting that week, okay? If we think most of their runs are going to be zone read and things like that, then we would call open sting. So we run a sting to the open side of the formation. If we wanted to run Billy's sting, we would run it to the back. So we got all of our different ways to run that same pressure based off of field sting, boundary sting, open sting, Billy sting. Andy means away from the back. So we got our different ways, and all we do is wherever the player area to go is, we say tight right sting right or tight left sting left. Run the same pressure. We can do the same thing with this, okay? I don't have any clips on here. But what we like to do, if we do face a tight end oriented running team, we would tag this as Sonny, check the trap. So if the tight end see area players to the field, we're running Sonny. So if you get this formation, okay, and there's no C area clear for tight end to the field, we would bring our pressure from the down. And that's something that we like doing versus two back teams or teams that run the ball to the tight end. Okay? So here's a look here. So this is field sign. So it's sonic lift. So you've got the blood path, okay, he's stepping to the guard, he's going to step in the back half of the center, he's working through his thing. On pass, he just slides his corners, play in the back half, he's going over. There's your field path right here on run. Anything like that out of the Big 12 Conference falls into this category, okay? And it's all based off the coverage. So for us, the coverage is what we call cover seven. It's more of a man-match type coverage to the field. This is a field boundary call, okay? And then we run our pressure to the boundary. We run our five-man pressure. We run whatever down pressure you want to run from the boundary. You can go four down and fire it back. Big gap, firing off the edge, kind of like tight sting. You're going to play the same coverage, okay? So from the coverage aspect, this corner's playing man-to-man. We're playing 3-over-2. For us, bracket means he's outside leverage on the slot, he's inside leverage on the slot, okay? This linebacker's got number 3. This guy right here, he's got number 2. The linebacker's got number 2 to the boundary, and the 3 safety's got number 1 to the boundary, okay? And for us Cowboys, just we also call it chop out of regular, but it's going to be a corner cat. So there's the same blood technique that you just saw from the Sonic outside back. He's running from the nickel line. So doing it from once this corner goes, he's normally going to be in the press alignment. We tell him to hold it as long as he can and put it on the snap. We had it happen to us in the West Virginia game. We ran the same Big 12 concept. Our safety came down there as a true freshman. Came down there and lined up 8 yards and played number two. And then they threw the ball over the top and just touched it. So what we're trying to do is invite them. The good thing about this is if you can get these guys coordinated the way that they're supposed to, you'll pressure run. It's really good. But if they ever show them, quarterbacks and high school quarterbacks are pretty good too. But the guys that we face, shit, as soon as they look back there and see any kind of tilt, shit, they're throwing 9 routes over the top of our corners. Okay, so for us, we would be, the full call would be men. Same front we talked about earlier. Where the star goes to the passing string, the jab goes away from the star, okay? And we go men, cavalry. Okay, the signal for that is just right here, cavalry. All right? So it's going to be in the corner. The outside back is in the blood. Everybody's running the same one step. The money's got number two. The pre-safety's got number one. And then we're playing our cover seven concept, three over two to the slot. So you should be in good position right there. The safety actually does a pretty good job holding it.
What's your cover seven concept?
So what, seven?
Your cover seven, what is that?
Cover seven to the field is a three over two, so we can play bracket where the star is outside and the safety's inside, double number two, and the corner's by himself. If we said seven switch, well, it puts the star inside and the safety outside, okay? We could play it with what we call mod, which is just true quarters. So we'd have a reroute, first to the flat, the corner playing man-to-man, the safety playing basic man on two. So we can change the technique of it, but it keeps us in high love what it faces. Okay, same deal here. This is just me, Mint Cowboy. Cowboy left. You can see these guys are playing bracket. He's outside leverage, he's inside leverage. He actually has number one. He has number two. This is a better look of what you want to see right here. Mark Schiller comes to him, he wants to work to the edge. Yeah, he's underneath the purple block. Corners are coming off the edge, and we get them invited into a room because they think they've got a count on the bottom.
Coach, if right here, if he goes on left right here, is he going to chase flat down one?
No, what we tell him to do is anytime. Anytime the ball is away, he wants to play cutback move reverse. Okay? So the back has a deal on this side, and he measures. We want him to sit down, and he's got the quarterback zone there.
What about the CN guy? The blood ticker.
The blood ticker? Oh, he's running him now.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's where you're talking about. Yeah, if he gets a zone this way, he's running that thing now. Anytime you got a guy traveling with you, you're what we call a force player. You want to go force the ball around the rough line. He should be. It's all that way. He should be running around through there. What we're trying to do here, we should get the ball either fit right in here at the back of the seat. Again, this guy has him man-to-man. When they cross, he's got that him, and he's got him. So we've got a fitter here. When the ball kicks out, it's going to get to him right out. You can see the coverage part here. He's playing man-to-man on number two. Corner should be playing man-to-man on one. Okay, you can see the back is playing man-to-man on three. Based off the coverage we're playing. And we can change the coverage. Okay. If we wanted to, we could say play cover two over the slot. Whatever three over two concept you want it to be, play that over there. Here's the pressure coming from the boundary. For us, it's a fastball call too, because if people are running fast, going no huddle. We could just go out there and go, if we called them, say we called Mint Strong 3 auto, we could go, hey, Mint Cowboy. Well, they're already lined up in the same front, now we're able to run a fastball call because it's a good boundary. tell these corners too, you go on the steel path, okay? He's covering number one, it allows him to flat step out of the top and come down. These are third down pressures, okay? These are really good. We were actually watching these, what we call bird dogs, the other day. Had our players executed a few plays the right way, we would have been 100% on this call right here, probably two picks for touchdowns, okay? We had a freshman out there that just didn't trap flat on one, and they catch the ball and tackles him. But I'm going to show you the concept here, all right? We our bird dogs, we use quarterbacks. NFL quarterback's names, okay? So far tells us it's coming from the field. If we ran anything like from the boundary, call it Brady or Breeze or something like that, okay? We use easy signals, okay? So this would be like Breeze, you know? We would use this as far or whatever. So it's easy communication, everything together. But what it is, it's actually a simulated pressure. It's only a four-man rush, okay? But you're going to play two high coverage, basically two-man, like we talked about. Okay, so right here, this is a hash field boundary call. Okay, so obviously far is going to come from the field. Anytime we come from the field, the star goes to the field, right? And he always comes. But we're going to run a wide path, okay, or a line path for us. So this is the defensive end of the field. We tell him this is the one time that you're asking to run by the quarterback. We want you to draw the tackle out. So get wide and run your ass up the field, okay? We're running a long stick path, okay? We're working vertical, contained through the B gap. This defensive end, again, this is a 4 down front. There's your four defensive linemen. He's going to play cut on number four. We number him from the field, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay? What we tell our linebacker is you always want to show away from the pressure, okay? We're trying to get the slide of the center to the over, all right? From a coverage standpoint, this corner is going to come out like he's bailing, playing bail man, and he's going to trap the flat. The safety should be showing dead in the middle of the field, and he's going to roll over the top. Free safety's down like he's playing flats. He's going to line up playing a half. We're going to trap the flats here with this corner, okay? And the money back, he's going to play stud on two like I talked about earlier. So if he's vertical or back to the ball, you got him in. If he goes out, get across that door. Okay? Same deal here. Everybody's doing the same thing on the back end. Right? The maximum he cut on trying to get on. He cuts on three. Three blocks he adds on. Okay, fill up the pass rush. So you get three by one. Okay? The money's cutting on two. The max cutting on three. There's your trap corner on both sides. The star always comes to the field. Run your ass past the quarterback and take the tackle. Okay, so this is going to be far right, okay? So in this formation here, okay, trap the flats, okay? This is a star right here. The star is going, he's high, he's working across. There's your man back, we're cutting on three, okay, which is the back. Your money's cutting on two, your safety's down, there's the middle of the field, there's the corner's trapping the flat. See, this guy's cutting on two. He's coming out, he's showing away, but he's cutting on two. It's a long way to go, but the quarterback's going to hold the ball because he's split safety. This is a better look right here. One thing we tell our blitzers, if you're blitzing, okay, your back steps up, we want them to go underneath. We tell them to break the pocket. Go underneath, get the quarterback off of this side. Okay? As we get, see right here, right there, he's expecting middle of the field coverage, okay? He's throwing a middle of the field route. He's going to hold it.
Now, when he's cutting the two, and he's coming out of there, and he gets a break across his face, does he just let him go across his face, or is it collision and let him go, or is he careful? Well, yeah, when your money's coming out to cut two, and he gets a slant, say for number one, like the previous play, he ran the slant, and he cut up underneath him. Now, if that slant continued, would he flip and go with him, or would he just pass him on?
Slant here?
Yes, sir.
No, his rule is, if he's vertical, you got it. If he's back to the ball, no matter if it's a 15-yard dig, 12-yard dig, yeah, 3-yard slant, you got it. So you play with the inside. It's like two man unless he goes out.
Okay.
If he goes out, you go to the next guy.
Okay.
Just like this linebacker did right here. He plays.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. No, he's taking.
So he's got him. He's got it. Okay. Because of the bubble slant, he came across his face while we're going in.
Well, if all right, let me say this. Let's just say he's part, number two's part. Okay, whoever's cutting on the two stays on him. If number three goes out and he's cutting on three, he goes to number one. So we always tell, hey, if you cut on three goes out, go to one. All you gotta do is count in the field. There's three, four, five, now goes to three, four, five. This is good where this is a see 23, he's pointing them out. There's my guy three right there. And he comes across, okay, now there, you can see, all right, there's number three. So all we tell them is if you don't know, it's from the field count 1, 2, 3, or number two, whoever you're cutting on, if they move, you recount it and declare who you're playing. So he knows if three goes out, who we go to. He knows if three goes out, we see you go to one, okay, go right there, is number one. He does a good job. Really good. It's a really good idea. Does that make sense? I mean, it's really, all you got to do is be able to count and know where the damn field's at and then line up and run. We're lined up at even front. We got 2 threes, 2 fives. Matt, hey, it's coming from over here. Okay, I'm lining up right here and where it goes, number three. Mine, you line up in the boundary. Now, where's number two? Show middle of the field, bring it from the field, you get a 4-man rush on them, you get a cheap pressure. Okay, last one I've got right here is a blitz. Okay, this is what we categorize everything is we've got our fire zone middle of the field, we've got our fire zone split safeties. Anytime we're under 5-man pressure, we won't play man to man, we categorize it as a zero. Okay, if we call cover one, okay, that's a low hold or high hold rushing four. If we categorize it as a blitz, okay, that's six or more. Okay, this is going to be more than six. Okay, it's called a model. It's a snake. We tell them anything that's a snake is going to be a blitz. Anything that's a bird, eagle, hawk, falcon, anything like that is going to also be a blitz. Okay, so we only run our blitzes, okay, in the red area, okay, the 18 or less, because we don't want to go out there and give up a 70-yard bomb. So this is called model, right? So it's all based off the back, okay? If the back is all set, that's how it sets the pressure, okay? So once the back's all set, you make a bull call, a bull lift. We're telling we're gonna take you no matter where you go.
Okay, here, it would be a full left, okay, so it's a star coming. Okay, the mat goes to the side of the bull call, the safety away goes to the opposite ADF. Everyone right here has got a key blitz, okay? The key to this whole deal is, though, if we want to time it up, when these two guys rush into the A-gap, you're hauling ass in the A-gap until the center tears your face off. When he tears your face off, you pop out with him. Okay? Because we know that when the center works here, they're throwing high from the step in front of the throat. Okay? That makes sense? You're going to get somebody free on this. It's just a matter of whether you see it or not. That's one of the reasons we also want to be ready. Okay, so this will be a bull left, okay? But he's coming off the edge, right? He's gonna bull attack. He's rushing through the B gap, the max back hits the A gap to the back. This is a free safety to get the A gap, and then you got these two guys coming off the edge. They're playing blitz cover. You can see here about 3 yards. The safety here is wrong. Once that guy engages him, he should pop away. He should pop back. Keep the center, get a guy free, break the pocket on the back.
So pretty much whoever the center's turning it off, it's popping
out. Yeah, but don't pop early because, I mean, in our league, the guy who pops out early, he's going to slam back on that guy. So we say you let him tear your face off, then you pop out.
Right there. At that point right there, that guy's committed, we want him to pop out. Okay, so we have a bull left, same look. Safety's coming off the edge, Mike's in the A gap, safety's getting the other A gap, playing blitz cover across the board.
Special up there when you got a bunch, trips up there.
Covers wise, we base it all off whatever routes they run. Okay. Typically sometimes we can lock a point, let these two guys play in and out. Sometimes if they run a different deal, we'll let him collision the point and take the back guy or whatever. It just depends on whatever route they run. But we do have a base way where we play like a freeway call, as we call it. It's our base way of camp rules of doing that. Once they're set, they're always set. Let it ride because we know we're playing man zeros and blitzes.
Who's your adjuster on the empty?
The adjuster on the empty, if he comes out this side, it'll be him. This mic back comes out here and comes off the edge. If he goes out this side, basically it'll be the safety coming out. So you these basically these three are coming in and out each way. You can see he finally gets it. He should be popping around the way trying to get out. But he ate his lock with the guy with the actual full slide, but he still don't have enough. 19 does a good job right here. He does a good job of holding the pack. say it and sit down, because the back came to it, and he knows he's got it. Two by two, so this is the full right for safety, maximum of the gate gap. We should be getting safety in the back, so he was late. Okay, the adjustment, this was in fall camp, okay, so we had some freshmen, and again, this guy's a freshman. All right, questions on that? No, it's not a whole lot of crazy pressures, but it gives you an idea of what we do. You can fire guys where you want them to be. We've got B-gap penetration, we've got A-gap, we've got off the edge, five-man pressures that are weapons, laying the fire zone, man, with Ripley's principles. We've got, you know, cities and states, okay, where we're dropping ends. Right, we don't do that as much anymore because it's just not as effective. Now we go into our Big 12s where you're playing a kind of a split safety look, but you're still bringing five and pressures wherever you want it to be. But what we feel like is once we get the coverage part set, we can do whatever the hell we want to do up here, lining up wherever we want to go. Third down, you saw what we did. We lined up with an easy deal. If they came out and the quarterback came up and killed the play, we would easily go out and say, hey, check, don't run this pressure, just go out and play two man. And that's the reason we like lining up. Even front, we've got exotic ways we line up and run the same pressures. We call them different names, but the coverage part on the back end is exactly the same. So bird dog blitzes. You know, blitzes are usually double edge pressures or something up the chute, something like that. But it's a lot of different ways you can do it. We got a million defenses. We just kind of pick and choose which ones we want to carry that year, or carry that week. Any questions? Rip Liz? No? Good? Appreciate y'all.
I said it's social media.
Yeah.
All right, guys, that's it. I think we have the social next coming up. Coach, you're going to be here for a few minutes.
Yeah.
We're going to talk to
yep.
local